Hello and welcome to AOR F1 Season 10 with F1 2013. It's Split 1 on PC. It's the opening round from Melbourne. My name is Justin, and joining me for today's commentary, it's the only man who has won an AOR PC Split 1 championship with F1 2013. It's Alex Gillen.
Hello, everyone. Well, that's quite an amazing stat, isn't it? I'm somehow the reigning champion on F1 2013. I mean, that's it seems like quite a while. And this is my first commentary in quite some time as well, so... Could be an interesting one. Let's see how it goes.
Yep, looking forward to it. Yeah, we might both be a little bit rusty, everyone, so bear with us. But we've got a 29-lap race ahead of us at this unique Albert Park circuit as we kick off the season in traditional fashion in Australia. The weather ahead of the weekend says rain is in the air, so things could get very exciting. Let's kick things off, though, with the qualifying report.
First quali of the season takes us to a wet Albert Park, where we have a comparison between Double D and Wycombs this week. As they both head into turn one, into second gear. Very tricky conditions here in this sort of weather. Nothing you would expect from the first round, getting thrown right into the deep end, I guess. And we see through this corner that Double D takes a little tighter line here, as well as the second corner after that. And Wycombs is at this point a fraction behind Double D on his pace. And you can also see at this interval that he is slightly ahead. Double D is playing around more with the fuel mixtures, while Wycombs stays in a, fixed one. And as you can see here, right through this tricky right-hander where the exit is very tricky, and Double D gets on the curb a little too much. So he compensates his exit there, and the guys are pretty much dead equal at this point, as you can see. Going through the fast left right-hander here, very tricky on a game pad for both these guys. Double D runs a little bit wide, Wycombs takes it a little more tidy, I have to say. Double D going down to standard mix, taking a lot of grass there, but keeping it within the lines of the track. And Wycombs slowly gains up, but yeah, Double D makes a little cut here, not really good from him, but okay. And he is in the slipstream now, so on this straight that will give him a little advantage over Wycombs, but we're still very close. Crossing the line, Double D posts a 29.389 in second. Wycombs follows with a 29.630, and Honey Badger stealing the first pole of the season. This has been Marco FD. Back to you, Justin and Alex.
Thank you for that quali comparison, Marco. I appreciate that. Honey Badger, as he mentioned, on pole position for Red Bull Racing in that full wet session. Double D taking second position on the front row of the grid in the Ferrari. He's followed by Hamish Sopwith and Wycombs in fourth position in the Marussia. His teammate Klawicki right behind him as well for Marussia. Marco FD down in sixth position. A bit of a surprise on that one there. 7/10 off of pole position. Then Posis, Coolcap 4716, Lucas Schumacher, and then just Magnus in all capital letters, which I have to say is a name I really enjoy. Lotus for NRL Kubica. That's Andrew, as I know him, so I'll probably call him Andrew quite a bit, qualifying in 11th position. Right behind him is Fissler in the other Red Bull Racing. So we got a Red Bull Racing car on in first position and 12th position. Big gap between them. Elcrack 91, also another American, driving for Mercedes in 13th position. Then Nicky FD, Titan of Racing, and Stobart, dude. That's a British thing, isn't it, Alex?
I don't know. I think I'm just going to stick with your pronunciation on that one.
So here we are at Albert Park for the first race of the season. It is looking quite nice. Unlike qualifying, not a drop in the air as these guys prepare to go racing for the first time in Season 10. Just having a look at Magnussen and also Lucas Schumacher. Marco FD, as we mentioned, in that Ferrari, starting from sixth position. Wycombs in fourth with his teammate Klawicki right behind him. Hamish Sopwith in third position, and then Double D. But there is your pole man, Honey Badger, on the front row of the grid, and at the tip of the spear as the lights are coming on now. We've got four lights. We've got five lights up into Rich Mix from Barco FD, and the lights are out, and away we go as the drivers head into turn one. It's a relatively short run. I expect we'll be seeing lots of side-by-side action there. Hamish Sopwith having a little bit of contact there with Double D. Double D with the inside line at turn number one. They're side-by-side at the exit, but it looks like Double D with a worse exit, and Wycombs actually losing out to his teammate, Klawitzki. I kind of missed what happened there to Wycombs, but clearly he lost out. Double D, though, still fighting with Hamish here. Pushed him off the track a little bit there, got a little bit aggressive. Lucas Schumacher trying to navigate his way through the traffic. Fizzler already up into eighth position after starting from 12th position, so he's gained a number of positions at this start. Klawitzki, as we also mentioned, up into fourth position ahead of his teammate, who's actually now dropped behind Marco FD, so Marco FD now into fifth position. And Alex, go ahead and talk us through the replay here.
Yeah, so we're going on a ball with Klawitzki here, just trying to run the outside. A little touch on the grass there, which can't have helped him too much. That was the oversteer there from Wycombe, which I think you missed. He's got a bit of oversteer, I think. I don't think there's any contact, but just did cost him a little bit of time there. That's allowed Klawitzki to go right past. Marco FD now having a look around the outside of Wycombe. He's managed to outbreak him there. And, looks like Wycombe's gone massively, massively deep then. So that's can't have helped Marco. Oh, having said that, he's just flowing straight around the outside there. So don't know how he managed it, but he managed to stay on the track there and take the position.
Yep, and actually it does look like Honey Badger is taking off into the distance as we're coming to the end of the first lap now. Hamish dipping a wheel in the grass through the penultimate corner there. Klawitzki trying to round the outside at the final corner of Hamish, and he's still got plenty of curves to use as he just drains that curves on the drag down towards to cross the start-finish line and start lap number two. Marco FD having a little peek outside, thinking about possibly having a look on his teammate. Hamish with a big mistake through turn number two. That's going to put Klawitzki side by side, and it's getting a little bit messy here as we head into turn number three. Hamish with the inside line. Klawitzki, though, with the cutback as Hamish runs off and into the gravel. That's going to lose him several positions as Marco now up into fourth position after starting from sixth, and he's right behind his teammate Double D as well. So the two Ferraris up into the top five right now. Of course, Double D did start in second position, so one Ferrari's down a position, but the other Ferrari's up a couple of positions, and hopefully we won't be seeing any sort of contact between the two drivers. Definitely no team orders or anything like that at this stage, obviously, with it being the first race of the season. Really, nobody has any sort of championship standing at this point, so there's definitely not going to be any sort of room given. I expect these teammates will be fighting each other quite hard as we head into the turn 11-12 complex on board with the Toro Rosso driver of Hamish. And once again, it looks like he's dropping off quite a bit. I mean, he dropped off of Honey Badger pretty quickly there, and it does look like he's dropping off of Marco FD now. I wonder if he's possibly got a higher downforce setting. I would expect a lot of these guys to just be running 1-1 wings, but Hamish possibly with a different setup, it seems like he's struggling.
Yeah, I mean, back in my day, it was always pretty much 1-1 wings a lot of the time. Sometimes you'd do a slightly higher front wing, but like I said, I'd be surprised if he's running two higher wings. But yeah, just at the moment, doesn't seem to quite have the pace. Although he's still within a second of Marco FD, according to that, so he's not dropping off too much. But these guys are battling. Marco's certainly in some dirty air there, so we'll keep an eye out for Hamish's pace there. We don't want to see him dropping back too far. And Klawitzki looks like he's come right up on Honey Badger, so he's setting a good pace, setting a fast lap of the race to 25-2. So it looks like we could be in for a change of leads here, Justin.
Yep, it looks like it. As you mentioned, he closed up right on him. I'm not sure if there was a mistake from Honey Badger. I don't think we have any sort of onboard footage with Honey Badger. Otherwise, I feel like we probably would have seen a little bit of that at some point already. As we move back on board to the battle for third position, Marco FD still sat behind his teammate for Scuderia Ferrari. Klawitzki has dropped off a little bit now, so he closed in massively towards the end of lap number two, beginning of lap number three, but he has sort of slowed down that pace now. I'm not sure if he's within DRS range. It's very close as they head into the high-speed section. Hamish, though, going purple in sector two, so he's actually pushing quite hard, even though there still is quite a large gap. As you mentioned, though, he is within DRS, according to the timing at the top left. Only time will tell if that's actually accurate, but here comes Marco FD up the inside through turn number 14 on Double D, but it doesn't look like he's able to make the move stick there as we head through the penultimate corner now. But Marco FD is looking very punchy as we're going to get DRS for the first time now as we come onto the start-finish straight. Double D is up into Rich Mix. I didn't see if he got DRS activated. Klawitzki, though, outside of the DRS range, 1.1 seconds to Honey Badger. So Klawitzki really needs to step on it and try and get in that DRS range for next lap.
Probably just want to mention at this point the breathing there. That's actually Kulwitzki. I think he was breathing into the mic, in case you're wondering what the hell is going on and why either me or Justin are breathing really weirdly into the mic. I just thought I'd point that out just before people get really freaked out and switch off purely because there's like weird ghosts behind them breathing on their neck or something. It's not that. It's just Kulwitzki. It's all fine.
Yep, he is pushing very hard, as is evident by the breathing. So we all know that Kulwitzki is giving it his all right now. Marco FD as well giving it his all, getting very close to Double D there, trying to make a move up at the inside of turn number 9. It looks like, oh, there's contact between them. No damage done, but Double D runs off the circuit into the grass, and that's going to allow Hamish through, and it looks like he's going to get a run on Marco. He's got the inside line as well for this very high-speed combination of corners at turns 11 and 12, and that is going to move him up into a podium position. So after starting from third and then dropping down, he's back up into third, but not if Marco has anything to say about it, as they're going to head side-by-side into turn number 13. This is, oh, and there's been contact there. Marco's been sent off into the gravel, and Hamish really unaffected. It sounds like seems like he didn't have too much of an issue there, as we're on board with Wycombs now. He's coming under attack from Nikki FD, and Nikki's going to have the inside line through the penultimate corner here, but if Wycombs can stick around, then he'll get the inside line for this final corner here. Who's going to get DRS, though? It looks like Wycombs gets DRS. I'm not sure if Nikki did. He's draining the rest of his curves. He's in rich mix as he crosses the line. He's going to have the inside line for turn number 1. Kulwitzki now into the pits for a set of the medium compound tires. Love the editing here with the split. I love seeing pits while we're seeing the racing. But Nikki's still attacking on Wycombs. We're on board with the Marussia driver heading into turn 3, and it looks like he's got him covered. He tried the switch back there, but of course it's a left-hand corner. Oh, he's tried it around the outside, and Wycombs, I don't think, saw that coming. Nikki really caught him napping there and moves up into fifth position.
Yeah, really, really, really sweet move there. Certainly not easy to do on there, and it looks like we're getting a mesh from race control here. He's involving Marco and Hamish under investigation. So that was a. I need to see a replay, but from what I saw, it looked like Marco did squeeze Hamish a little bit, and Hamish just had nowhere to go and ended up, unfortunately, Marco ended up in the gravel. But yeah, to my eye, it did look like perhaps that was Marco's fault, and of course he ended up worse. And oh, looks like there's lots of lag there. And Kulwitzki, as unfortunately, having just come out of the pits, I believe, he's now unfortunately lost his wing. I think there was only a little bit of damage, though. I think he lost his whole wing, so he might be able to get away with that, but it's certainly not going to do his pace any favors at all.
No, not at all. And as you mentioned, especially because he just stopped, so he's got a big, long, medium stint to try and make these tires last. I expect it's going to be either a 2 or 3 stop race, probably predominantly a 2 stop race for this 29-lap race. And as we mentioned, Kulwitzki has already come in. We're on board with Schumacher there briefly as we cut back on board with Hamish. And yeah, there is going to be no further action on that one. So I think you were right in your assessment of that, Alex, as Hamish takes the lead of this race. Which means Honey Badger's into the pits, and Wycombs is into the pits as well. Kulwitzki is going down the start-finish straight, and he's going to come out handily ahead of his teammate. So he's back up into the top 10 now, and he's got Honey Badger just ahead of him. So this is essentially the battle for the lead, and it looks like he's gotten a great run out of turn number 2. He's going to have to go around the outside of turn number 3, but I think Honey Badger just came out of the pits, so he's going to have pretty cold tires, and it looks like he's made it work. He's going to get the inside line now for turn number 4, and he moves himself up ahead of Honey Badger into P9, but what is effectively the lead of this race.
Yes, absolutely. That's quite a nice move there, just around the outside. He pretty much had the move done for the corner, but just needs to keep his head under braking, which he managed to do nicely there. So yes, up ahead of Honey Badger there. And interesting how Hamish has stayed out there to another lap, it looks like, and Double D as well on these super soft tyres. I mean, we saw the first pit, I think it was lap 4 even, wasn't it, Kulwitzki?
Yeah,
so 2 laps longer. That's quite a long way longer. So I wonder if we could be seeing some differing strategies. But look on the look. Oh, wow, yes. Ooh. Just going to mention, looking on the right-hand side there, the front left does look very worn, so I expect they'll box this lap. And indeed they do, because that front tyre is now gone. You just can't go. It does rather fall off a cliff in this game, so you just lose all front left grip there. So I'm not surprised seeing them box in. So interesting to see where they come out, though, Justin.
Yep, very, very interesting. We should see very soon here, actually, as they're coming out. Marco FD also into the pits as well. He's just heading in and going into lean mix. He's already on optimal, actually, so Marco FD obviously pushing very hard. He did well to get up into that fourth place position after starting from 6th. We're on board with Wycombs. Oh, and that is some definite contact with the barrier there. That's going to lose him an end plate. Kulwitzki now coming under attack from the Honey Badger. And he just kind of pushes his way through. A little bit of contact there. I don't think any sort of damage for either of the drivers. But Hamish, not too far behind, actually. I think he's just about within DRS range of Kulwitzki. So we're just about in the same order that we were. Honey Badger, once again, in the lead. Hamish sort of in that third place seat. overall as it stands right now. But now it is Klawiczki that is effectively in second position. And I do believe all of these drivers are on the primes. I don't think anybody went on to a second set of the Super Softs. And unfortunately, I did not see who started the race from the mediums, because of course everybody qualified on the wets. So that gave the drivers free choice, but it looked like the majority of the drivers, at least up at the front, were opting for the Super Softs, because of course the medium's so slow on high fuel, as Hamish gets a little bit of a dirty air effect, some severe understeer at the exit of turn 11, switching into turn 12 and missing his apex there. And that's certainly not going to do him any favors in his quest to try and catch up to Klawiczki, as we're coming to the end of lap number 7 now. Was he close enough to get DRS, though, is the question. I don't think Wycombs is close enough to Andrew or NRL Kubica, as he's had some sort of heavy issue. I don't know if that's a lag that we're seeing from Andrew, but it seems like he's having technical problems.
Oh, yeah, someone else started going very slow there. Oh, looks like, was that damage there something there? Marco? It's LCrack 91, but no, I think he might have been slow on the exit there. Perhaps Marco just managed to make the move stick and avoid contact. But yes, it seemed like lag, didn't he? He was going so slow. Perhaps maybe he had a wheel issue or something. I'm not too sure, but. Anyway, I'm sure I'm sure he wouldn't mind a free position. That's always nice, regardless of what the other driver's issue is.
Right. I think Andrew Kubica, I think he might have started on the prime tires, because he's up in the top 10 right now, and he started in, I think it was 11th position. I don't have the bottom part of the qualifying standings, but so I don't think he's stopped yet. I think he's still on his opening stint. It was crucial for Marco to get by him, because he's got the much fresher prime tires, so he really needed to just kind of clear that car as quickly as he could, and thankfully it didn't appear much of an issue for him. Klawiczki trying to defend from Hamish now, heading into turn 11 once again, and Hamish with that slipstream looked like he was closing in, and it looked like Klawiczki was thinking about defending a little bit, you know, hanging to the inside, but speaking of defending, Lucas probably should have defended there, as Fissler now moves up into 10th position. Lucas dropping out of the top 10, out of the points paying positions, as we're coming to the end of lap number 8 now, and I expect with the drivers stopping at around lap 4 or 5, they're probably going to be trying to do 12 laps or so. If they're doing a two-stop, they're going to be looking to do anywhere from between 10 and 12 laps on the set of the prime tires here. Ooh, Klawiczki going a little bit wide off the circuit there, and it looks like Honey Badger's starting to break away again.
Yes, absolutely. It looks like Honey Badger's got some good pace, although Double D does manage to set the fast lap of the race there. But don't forget, Klawiczki's got that. He looks like he's missing the left-hand side of his front wing, so he's showing some pretty good pace. And he also pitted earlier as well, so I think once he gets the front wing fixed, he could have some serious pace towards the end of this race, which of course will be in the next pit stop. But also there is quite a bit of contact ahead there as someone runs by. Titan Racing there, very, very close. Klawiczki squeezes through, and so does Hamish as well, so that's been very, very costly for Titan Racing there. Lost a couple of positions just because he ran wide. I'm not sure if there was any contact. I think there was some, but I wasn't really paying enough attention to see who's at fault. Did you see any of that, Justin?
No, I missed the... Yeah, if there was contact, I don't think there was any damage. I didn't see any bodywork flying off.
No. It looks like just a bit of contact, and yes, like I say, it's really hard to comment much further, but looks like Double D's had a great run for that last set of corners, though. He looks like he's going to take Titan Racing as well. So there's been quite a miserable lap there for Titan Racing. He's potentially going to lose 4 positions if you include Honey Badger as well. So he won't be too happy at the end of this lap. We'll see if he can fight his way back through.
And now Magnussen is sort of getting involved. I think he was another prime runner, as Double D runs into the back of him, pushes him very wide through the penultimate corner there. He's going to have the inside line now through the final corner. But of course, Double D is going to get DRS, since the DRS detection zone is back towards the middle of Sector 3 right there. Klawiczki again under attack from Hamish. You can hear the breathing. You can hear him pushing so hard right now. It's getting very intense. Oh, I'm sorry. That was Honey Badger. But now Hamish gets involved, making it 3 wide into turn number 3. Hamish has the inside line. He's taking a very interesting line through that corner, and that's going to cause him to lose out to Double D as Honey Badger hangs on to the lead of this race. Klawiczki in second. Hamish now attacking back on Double D. I think Hamish has spent more of this lap in the grass than he has on the circuit, and he's down into fourth position now, and probably very frustrated with how that all worked out, but that was incredible. 3 wide into turn 3, and Albert Park is not a very wide circuit.
No, absolutely not, and I think Hamish more or less scared himself off the circuit there, because he was very, very far away. He was right on the extreme right-hand side with his 3 wide, and almost you could probably get 5 wide if you tried down there, so he was about perhaps a bit excessive, and some quite sort of evasive, but it was quite some quite dirty driving there. So Albert Park is known for, in this game, is known for being very prone to cutting and extending, but I think Hamish, that was quite severe, so he needs to keep an eye there. It looks like Double D's managed to take Klawiczki as well, so Klawiczki's now falling back, and that was a quite sweet move there. That was Weletzki by double D, but looks like it's been pushed wide by Hamish, though. Kulwitzki straight out into the gravel, and that's a worst-case scenario, because not only do you lose the speed from the gravel, the gravel also stays on your tyres. You see a little bit on the left-hand side there, and you just slow for the next couple of corners as well, so not great news for Kulwitzki there. He's losing lots of positions, unfortunately, for him.
Yeah, and unfortunately, the final corner is, of course, a fairly quick. It's not as slow as the penultimate corner, but a fairly quick and nearly flat-out corner. And with him having the dirty front left, that's just going to give him loads of understeer. And that's heading onto the longest straight on the circuit as well. So that's just going to be hindering him all the way to turn one. On board with Double D once again in that second place position. He's got Hamish just behind, Honey Badger up ahead. And I don't think he's within DRS range yet. We switch to Ycoms now, Klawitzki's teammate. In P6, he started in P4, so he's down a couple of positions as it stands right now. He's got Magnussen just ahead, though. And again, I believe Magnussen actually started on the prime tires. And I think he's still running his first stint, actually, believe it or not. Especially based on how other people overtook Magnussen. They just kind of flew right by him, which kind of indicates to me that his tires are quite a bit older versus the cars around him. But Klawitzki is just about within the DRS range of Hamish, but only just. He's already used all of his curves on this lap, which is nice to have back. Of course, F1 2014 and F1 2015, there's no button for ERS usage or anything like that. So it's nice having the strategy of curves returning to the AOR leagues. Double D trying to get DRS off of Honey Badger here. Of course, again, the detection zone was a little ways back, and he does. He gets DRS, drains the rest of his curves. He's in Rich Mix as well. He might be getting a little bit of a slipstream, and Klawitzki now into the pits at the end of lap number 11. So that's a fairly early stop. Again, he stopped on lap number 4, so he only completed 7 laps on that set of the prime tires, but of course he's got the damage to his front wing. He's getting a new wing put on now and missed what tire compound he was going through. Honey Badger there with a big mistake coming out of turn number 3. Double D's going to go around the outside at the exit of turn number 4, and that's going to give him the inside line at turn 5, and he moves up into the lead of this race. Very surprising there to see a mistake from the guy running in first position. He's still right behind him, so it's not like Double D can relax now, but that was a fairly easy move. I mean, he got the opportunity and he grabbed it.
Yes, absolutely. It looks like a mistake from Honey Badger there, and I think we might have seen a couple of mistakes. I mean, obviously we've not got his footage, but from what we've seen, I think he has made a couple of mistakes, and it looks like we're going to get a replay here of Ycoms coming through the first turn. Yeah, looks like it's Nicky FD directly behind him, so I think we're about to see an overtake. He's actually got DRS, and he's using his curves, so he's going to have some decent straight line speed. Looks like Nicky's going to have a little look at the inside, is he? Oh, looks like, was that a bit of contact, perhaps? Or did he just run wide? Couldn't quite see, but it certainly cost him the position, and probably about a second or two at a time. And just briefly want to go back to the Klawitzki's strategy there. I think he must be on a 3-stop now. I mean,
yeah,
you know, the primes can probably just about do 12 laps, and it's been 12 laps, and he's used a set of options and a set of primes. So I think he'd do very, very well to pull off a 2-stop at this point. So I think he will certainly be on a 3-stop. And Ycoms as well coming in fairly early. It was Ycoms starting on the primes, I forget now. I think Ycoms might...
No, he started on the options.
He did start on the options. Okay, so it looks like I think he maybe might be going for a 2-stop as well then. 3-stop rather. We'll see how this plays out, but that does seem still fairly early. It looks like was that Honey Badger diving up the inside of Double D. Honey Badger seems like a really quite aggressive driver. I've not witnessed him drive before at all. But at the moment, he does seem... Well, to my eye, a little bit inconsistent, but certainly very aggressive. So he could be a good driver to watch this season if he's going to continue to be this fast as well. And looks like Double D's managed to take the position straight back there and pushes Honey Badger wide a little bit, which gives him a little bit of breathing space. So he's going to try and push now, I suspect, and try and pull away from him to try and get away from some of his aggressive moves.
Yep, and on board with Klawitzki now. He's essentially a pit stop ahead of that Williams, though, of Titan of Racing. I believe who that was, and so he clears him pretty quickly with those extremely fresh tires. Oh, and the bollard! Hamish makes contact with the bollard at the inside of turn number 11, and that has completely killed his momentum, and he's just dropping off the back of Honey Badger. He's definitely not going to get DRS this time around as we're rapidly approaching the halfway point of this race now. Hamish with quite a bit of fuel, though. He has over 2 laps of fuel still to play with, which we've seen some drivers like Marco already running on optimal, so we're already seeing fuel stuff starting to come into play here. We're on board once again with Lucas Schumacher. He's in 13th position. running behind Wycombs. He's got Kubica behind him, a.k.a. Andrew. I'm going to keep saying that. Hamish looks like he did not get DRS. I kind of missed it there. Honey Badger, though, appears to have had a mistake. Yeah, Hamish does not get DRS, but clearly Honey Badger has had some sort of issue at the end of lap 13 or the beginning of lap 14, and that's brought Hamish right up to the back of him despite making contact with that bollard on lap number 13, and he is getting very, very close in the dirty air, struggling to put the power down and using all of the circuit and then some, getting a little bit of grass on his tires as we head into turn number 6. And he is very close behind us. Kulwitzki sets the fastest lap of the race. I believe one of the few drivers to dip into the 123s, possibly the only driver to dip into the 123s with a 123.9 there. Big gap back to Nicky, which is something we really haven't pointed out yet. It really seems like the top three have kind of broken away from the rest of the field.
Yeah, absolutely. And as Kulwitzki's now not part of that top three, could pull off his three stop. I mean, he could still recover here, but at the moment he's not part of the top three at least. And I'm just watching Hamish. He seems to be exceeding the track limits quite a lot, both on the inside and the outside. And there we are. There's another cut, and it's quite a lot. And I'm not one that's a stickler. I'm known myself, or I was known myself for perhaps cutting its end a little bit too much. So if I'm saying that, you know, it's quite bad. So and again, massive
oh
cut.
Oh God.
There. So he's going. Oh, it's Honey Badger diving into the pits. Well, actually, that seems like a bit more of a normal time to stop. Perhaps a little bit early, but again, I'm not got any data on the actual strategies and the tyre life expectancies, but Double D manages to take a nice comfortable lead now from Hamish, who's going to now probably try and push. And the other thing I noticed is already quite a big, we're more or less halfway through this race now, there's already quite a big rubbered in line, and it is vital to try and stay on the line, because you do get a lot more grip when you see that dark black line there. It is very, very vital to stay on that, because there's a lot less grip off the line, so that's something drivers need to be wary of as well.
Yeah, and Kulwitzki going purple there with a 123.6, 3/10 faster than his previous fastest lap, as he just gets by a lapped car there and continues on down the road on lap number 15 with these fresh tires. And like you said, I really don't see him. He must be three stopping, as you mentioned, because he came in very, very early. I think, it was lap 11. So unless he's planning on doing 18 laps on a set of medium tires at Albert Park, I'm fairly certain that he's going to be stopping again. But the real question is, I suppose, whether or not it's going to be for another set of the prime tires or if he's going to try another set of the super softs at the end of the race. That's still to be determined. Of course, the tires will have slightly better life as the track rubbers in, as you were mentioning, Alex. And there is that extremely dark line. It's very, very dark through turn 13 there. But as you mentioned, Hamish trying to close up on Double D right now. He was just outside of DRS range last we checked when there was a split, and it looks like that has continued to be the case. I believe it was about 1.6 seconds. Let's see it as he crosses the line. What's the time going to be? The gap is 1.2 seconds now, so he's still outside of DRS, but closing in massively, gaining about 4/10 on Double D, but he's completely messed up the exit of turn number one there, which put him offline for turn number two. It hasn't actually lost him too much there. It was still 1.2 seconds was the gap. I don't know if that was still the split as they crossed the line, but we're back on board with Kulwitzki. Once again, setting another 123.9, so still consistently in the 123s for Kulwitzki, as Double D actually appears to be doing some fuel saving as he's gone down into lean. He's back up into standard now for this slightly faster section. Since we're going to play the back in my day game, I like to use sector 3 for fuel saving at this circuit. As you come out of 11 and 12, the high speed corners, I would put it down into lean and then use that for 13, 14, 15, and 16. Wow, and Marco FD with a big corner cut there. He gets a corner cut warning, but it doesn't look like he's gained much of an advantage. It's Nicky FD versus Marco FD. And Pasas just comes out of nowhere there in the McLaren, just flies by Marco. Nearly had a look at Nicky there, but Marco's coming back at him now, coming out of the high-speed corners. He's going to have the inside line for turn number 13, and let's hope things go a little bit better for him this time than the last time he went side-by-side. And it looks like Pasas is still on the left-hand side there. He's going to try and go around the outside, but he couldn't, and Marco does go ahead. And now Double D into the pits at the end of lap number 16 in his Ferrari, going on for another set of the prime tires.
It actually looks like Nicky D ran a little bit wide. Nicky FD, rather, ran a little bit wide there in that last corner. I think he might have boxed though, so he's actually in the pits, but he certainly lost probably a good half a second or so there. And it looks like Kulwitzki's closing right up on Cool Cut now. Of course, he's going to have, if presuming everyone else is pretty much on, he's actually letting him through there. That seems massively generous, almost like he's a lapped car. Perhaps he thought it was rather inevitable that Kulwitzki was going to get through, so decided not to battle it. But he should have, providing everyone else is on two stops, he should have some decent tyre left till the end now. And do you want to just commentate on this replay here, Justin?
Yep, Lucas he's got a car on his inside. I believe that's Fizzler. Oh my gosh! And Fizzler just moves over on the left on him, just pushes him off the circuit. That's a bit of a dirty move there. Who knows what it looked like on Fizzler's side? You know, that could have been lag related or something. But Lucas does well to keep it out of the barrier and get everything slowed down for that turn 13 corner. Double D now coming out of the pits. This is another replay of Double D coming out of the pits, and I believe that's. Oh, gosh, and that's been contact with Magnussen, and that sent him off the circuit. That was right after Magnussen had set the fastest lap of the race with a 123.1. Very, very fast lap from Magnussen there. Kulwitzki now running behind the other McLaren of Pasas as we're heading through the tightest form part of the circuit, aside from really, you know, turns 3 and 4 maybe. I don't know if that was a lag bubble there, but Pasas goes right off the circuit into the grass. Looks like Marco FD is into the pits, and Kulwitzki continues on with his alternate strategy. But I believe he stopped one more time than Marco, and he's only a few seconds behind him. So I don't know if Kulwitzki's three-stop strategy is going to win him the race, but he definitely seems to be in the top five still. He's very competitive, I would say.
Yeah, absolutely. Yes, he has shown great pace, even with the broken wing there during that second stint. He still had pretty decent pace. And now with that fixed wing, he's shown some really, really good pace. It looks like Hamish is actually still out in the lead. You saw his front left tire was really quite worn, though. He's on lap 18.
Well, just came out of
I'm not sure exactly what lap he pit. I think it was lap 6, wasn't it? I think he went quite long. So he pit on lap 6. That means he's now done 12 laps on these primes. So he's, he's presumably going to go primes again now. Well, that will only be 11 laps. So he should have a nice, easy final stint here. Presumably he is going to pit this lap.
Primes,
presumably he's not going to stretch it so far to put another set of super softs on. I mean, that would require probably about another three or four laps, so I doubt he'll do that. He'll probably just pit this lap for another set of primes, but he's done a good job in this middle stint to mean that he's got an easier job in his final stint in terms of tyre life. And looks like Lucas there just runs a little bit wide, and Nicky FD just comes flying up inside there, so a pretty good move, and manages just about keep it inside the track limits as well. So nice clean move by Nicky there.
Yeah, Lucas kind of bouncing in and out of the points-paying positions all race long. He was in 10th there and got overtaken, and now back down into 11th position as Double D using all of the circuit and then some. We've got a couple of McLarens very close on the circuit. They actually made contact. Double D is going to try and go around the outside of Magnussen at the final corner as Pasas goes into the pits for what I assume is his final stop and probably onto the prime tires. And we've got Hamish just now coming out of the pits, as you were mentioning, his last set of tires quite destroyed. So he's coming out of the pits now, and I assume for the final time he is on the primes. So he is going to have a nice, as you mentioned, easy final stint, just 11 laps on that set of primes, which we know is very possible, especially in the late stages of the race with this much rubber down on the circuit. Lucas now back up into 9th position, so he continues bouncing in and around the edge of the points-paying positions. He's got Marco FD all over the back of him in that Ferrari, but he's too far back to do anything about it into turn number 3 on lap number 19 here, and then now into the left-hander. I really like turn 4 there, actually, and turn 5. I think those are, other than maybe 11 as well, probably my favorite corners on the circuit. And Marco is probably not going to be able to find a way by. I imagine his next opportunity, well, it actually could be right here because Lucas with a bad exit coming out of turn number 7 there, and that allows Marco to just swoop up the inside. Wow, that was a very easy move.
Yeah, it looks like I think Lucas might have got out of the way of him there because obviously Marco is the reigning AOR champion. He won the F1 2014 championship season 9, yes, I think he was just, I don't want to say scared off the track, not so bad as that, but I think he was perhaps a little bit too generous there and probably thought that the move was inevitable, so it's just easier to let him through there so he can just crack on with his own race. And it looks like Kulwitzki is currently in the lead, but got Honey Badger for very close company behind. He's going to have DRS, so this should be probably a fairly easy move with the DRS. He's even going to lean, and yes, he's already well past coming to the braking zone. And of course, now Honey Badger will also get DRS into this next zone. There's only one detection point on this track, so a nice easy move for Honey Badger there.
Yep, Hamish currently in 5th position, but Kulwitzki still has another stop to do, while Hamish does not, or at least we assume Kulwitzki has another stop to do. And last I checked, it was about a 14-second gap between them, so Kulwitzki's going to really need to push extremely hard if he wants to try and challenge for the win. At the moment, it's actually looking pretty good for Hamish, I would say. The real question is whether or not Honey Badger is stopping again, though. And that was somebody was on minus one. I missed who that was. It was a red car. It was either a Marussia or a Ferrari. But somebody's actually already on minus one fuel. And Hamish still with plus one fuel as we're now into the final third of this race. He gets another quarter cut warning there. He's got to be careful about that. Of course, acquiring too many of those, and he could suffer a penalty. Double D going through turns 10 and 11. Very high speed sort of chicane. Nice change of direction. in between the two of them. He's on optimal right now, and he's going into lean in Sector 3, as is my strategy that I like to do. Hamish appears to be closing up a little bit on Magnussen here. Last time through the split, it was a 1.8-second gap between the two of them. Let's see, as we come to the end of Sector 3, Hamish looks to have things under control, getting very close to Magnussen, but we already passed the DRS detection, but Magnussen pits anyway for what I assume is his final stop of the race, as he's going in on lap number 20. Kulwitzki just coming out of the pits. This could be very exciting between Kulwitzki and Hamish. No, but Hamish goes flying by as Kulwitzki is still cruising along in the pit lanes. Wycombs still into the pit. Kulwitzki hadn't even stopped yet. I apologize. Wycombs is into the pits as well. Lots of action here. I assume all of these are going to be their final stops. I haven't seen anyone go onto the super softs though.
No, yeah, I think perhaps they thought it was a bit of a stretch, so they just thought they'd push very, very hard indeed on the primes rather than having to nurse super softs, because it's quite a big tyre lap difference. I mean, you can get 12 laps, that looks about the primes, and you can probably only get, well, I mean, Hamish got 6 just about, didn't he? But they were very worn, so probably realistically sort of 5 laps or so. So I think there's just the super softs just don't last long enough. I think just for the first stint, maybe, while you're battling, you could do with that grip, but beyond that, I think the prime is the better race tyre here at Melbourne.
Yep, and Titan of Racing, though, putting in a purple time, a triple purple sector, as Crofty would say, and doing a 122.8, I believe it was, 122.9. But Hamish now going purple. He's moving extremely quickly, trying to close in that gap to Double D a little bit over 3 seconds as it stands right now. You can see Double D just ahead on the minimap at the bottom left as he is battling with Honey Badger for the lead of this race. And I believe he's within DRS range based on the dots on the minimap there. But Hamish just needs to continue on. Let's see if this is indeed a purple lap for him as he crosses the line. What's it going to be? It is a 122.2, quite a bit faster than Titan of Racing's time, about 6.5 tenths faster. Very, very quick lap time there. And now that gap is down to 3.2 seconds up ahead. And of course, you know, that's everybody sees that fastest lap message up at the top as we switch on board with Double D. And he is looking at that right now, looking up at his monitor at the top of his screen, seeing that 122.2, and then seeing that the man putting in that time right now is the guy that's behind him. And let's see once again as we cross the split. He's gained another half of a second, 2.7 seconds now is the gap to Double D. It's getting very close in the top three.
Yes, absolutely. So Hamish now looking like he's really, really hungry for this win, pushing really hard here.
Nice.
Like I say, set some really impressive lap times. And I said he did 12 laps in the primes in the previous stint, so he's only got to do 11 on this, so he won't have to worry too much about the tyres.
Kulwitzki
now pushing to the end, I expect. And Double A here through the chicane. Looks like Honey Badger ran a little bit wide ahead of him. Now it's a 2 second gap. There's pretty much just over 2 second gap between all three of them in the lead here. So got a little bit of time to wait now, but there's only 7 laps to go. So I think we're all hot up between these top three and the lead in very short order.
Yep, as the lap counter ticks down, the desperation starts to set in, and we might see some mistakes start to happen. And was that Honey Badger into the pits? It was Honey Badger into the pits for what is probably a stop for the super softs, I imagine. If he's stopping at the end of lap 22, that would mean he's probably going to try a 7-lap stint on the super soft tires. Of course, the track a little bit more rubbered in now, so I expect he'll probably get he'll get some really nice fast laps, but probably on lap number 28, 29, his tires will be a little bit dead. So he's going to have some making up to do as Kulwitzki now coming down the start-finish lane. Is he going to come out ahead of Honey Badger? He does, but of course, Honey Badger has the benefit of those brand new, extremely fresh, super soft tires, and he is not far behind Kulwitzki, as Kulwitzki is either upset about something or excited about something. I'm not sure. My German is no Sprechen is a German, but Nicky FD ahead of Kulwitzki right now, actually. I wasn't really aware that Nicky FD had kind of taken fourth position, but he might be due for a stop at the end on the super softs as well, potentially.
Yes, absolutely. So it's good to see Kulwitzki. So, of course, he's now made his final pit stop, would you believe? So he's got 6 laps left to go. And as you said, if Honey Badger is indeed on the super soft, which I assume he is behind him, he's going to be under some extreme pressure. It looks like he already is. Looks like he must be on the super soft because Honey Badger is already all over him there. And so I suspect he'll be losing that position sooner rather than later. In fact, it might even be right now, about now. A bit of contact there, which is giving Kulwitzki a bit of a boost of speed. And he just turns it in there and just does not leave him any room. All fair, that was quite firm, but fair. And I think Honey Badger must have used most of his curves. And look at Kulwitzki's curves. He's got almost all of his curves left. So he shouldn't have too many problems keeping away on the first DRS zone, at least. The second DRS zone, though, however, between turns 2 and 3, could be a totally different matter altogether.
Yep. He took turn 14 beautifully right there. That was actually beautiful. I really enjoyed that one as he was actually closing in there. Double D is still leading this race ahead of Hamish right now after Honey Badger's pit. And we're on lap number 24 now, so we've just got about five and a bit of laps still remaining in this race. Hamish has been closing up on Double D this whole time. He's definitely within DRS range, no doubt about that. Less than 3/10 between the two of them as they cross the end of Sector 1 and start Sector 2. And it looks like Double D is going to defend the inside line here. Kind of stayed in the middle of the circuit there and ended up not defending, and he's been pushed wide by Hamish right off the circuit through the gravel, through the grass. That's going to drop him down into second position. Let's get a replay here of seeing it from both drivers' perspective here. We can see what went on with Hamish. So, and you know, we kind of alluded to this earlier. Sometimes people see very different things. And oh yeah, that was very strange. As you can see from Hamish's point of view, there was a solid 3 feet between the two of them, or a meter if you're a European type. But yeah, that was definitely you know, Hamish thought he was just doing the right thing. He thought he was just staying behind him, in fact.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you have got to be aware of that with this game, though. I mean, it does have a lag bubble. It's not like it's, you know, new, and it was a surprise to everyone. Looks like Kruiskin used all of his curse to fly past, I think that was Nicky FD there, and looks like Honey Badger's going to look up the inside, though. He's going to try and make a double move. Doesn't quite manage to make it stick, though, but Honey Badger is absolutely desperate to get past now. He's going to have another look on the outside here. He's certainly got superior grip to Klubutsky, and I think he's still just about alongside him. So, he's not leaving him any room, though, so let's hope he's not. And I think he was, and I think, unfortunately...
Oh, he went off!
Yes, Honey Badger has indeed ended up in the gravel there behind him, so looks like Honey Badger must have been alongside Klubutsky, so perhaps not great driving there by Brad Klubutsky. Should have known he's alongside him. And yeah, just continue what I was saying about the lag bubble. I mean, like I say, it's not a new phenomenon. It's something that's had last incident is under investigation. Oh no, sorry, the Double D and Hamish incident is under investigation.
Yeah.
But again, you know, it's funny enough, I'll just say about that. The lag bubble isn't new. It's you know, everybody knows about it, and you've got to be aware of it. You know, you know, those last couple of feet, or you know, last meter or so, as you said, depending on where you're from. you know, you just got to leave that amount of gap. Pretend your car is that extra meter long. Because you know, it's that's just the game. Particularly, you know your connection as well. You know, Hamish might have a slow connection, so you know, he'll know pretty much. I didn't ever have much of a lag bubble because I had a good connection, but you know, you have got to be aware of that. And it looks like there's no further action between Double D and Hamish there, probably because that was a lag-related incident. You know, Hamish, it didn't appear he did anything wrong, but that's what's so tricky about this game with the lag bubble. It's, that's a big lag issues there for Hamish. That's not good. And
that's probably what caused the incident, I would imagine.
Well, I mean, that was frame rate issues. It was internet issues having before. It was ping issues. So luckily they've resolved them. I had that before. I've had that before in Monaco and ended up actually losing my wing. And it wasn't good. But it looks like Hamish's issues have resolved themselves. But he'll need to hope that doesn't come back again, because that could certainly be a race-ending issue they're having. That's those serious frame rate issues.
Yep, yeah, for sure. That could be a serious problem, especially with only 4 laps remaining in this race. We're on board with Wycombs, who is just inside the top 10, currently stands to gain 1 championship point after starting from 4th place on the grid, which is probably a little bit of a disappointment for the Marussia driver. But he's got a couple of cars just ahead of him. He's got the McLaren of Haas just ahead of him, and it looks like one of the Lotus cars just ahead of the McLaren, and I assume that's probably Cool Cat, if I'm not mistaken, because I believe Andrew is out of the points at the moment, Kubica. But Wycombs getting pretty close behind these guys, and it looks like there's a fourth car involved now. I don't know if that's a lap car or if this is for position, but up ahead we can see there's some more battling going on, and it is actually the other McLaren of Magnussen, who just got passed by, I believe, Cool Cat. Paz is now possibly going to try and get by Magnussen here as we head into turns 11 and 12, using all of the circuit, running a little bit off the circuit even there. I didn't see any major corner cuts there through turn number 12, but Paz is, they're kind of in the same order. I expected more battling, but Cool Cat now ahead of Magnussen, who's ahead of Paz, and then Wycombs in 10th position, but he's gotten very close to Paz at the end of lap number 26 here. Again, I allude to that desperation that starts to set in at the end of the race, as we've got some side-by-side battling between Cool Cat and Magnussen. Cool Cat with the inside line and the better exit, but Wycombs just goes flying past both of the McLarens. He's up into 8th position. Can he get into 7th position? He breaks very late. There's some lag. No surprise there from the American. Of course, Wycombs, I believe, from Switzerland, so that's a very big distance to be communicating data over the internet. But Wycombs just about grabbing 3 positions in the space of just a few corners. He's up into 8th now, just behind Cool Cat. A little bit of oversteer there as he's in the dirty air of that Lotus car ahead of him. But man, this is some pretty exciting racing happening for what is 7th position. Oh, and Cool Cat runs a little bit wide there. Wycombs with a fantastic exit, and he's up into seventh.
Yeah, some great racing there by Wycombs. Just in the space of half a lap, he's gained three positions there. So, so some really, really good driving. And must say as well, his track limits are exemplary as well. He's not, obviously, he's not done any cuts or extends, which is always good to see. So some really good driving there. Looks like Hamish now not got any more frame issues. Run a little bit wide there, but he's only now got two laps to go, including this one now. So it looks like he's got quite a big gap. I don't know exactly how long he's going to stay on board long enough to see the actual gap. But pretty consistent stuff there as well. Looking at the top right there, only a tenth down on his previous lap. Didn't get to see the gap there, but it does look quite substantial.
4.3.
So, Hamish has got a pretty substantial lead there. As it looks like Magnussen, I'm not sure what was recording this on, but it's not the best quality, I'll be honest. It looks like along the right side there, his front left is particularly worn. So he might start to struggle a bit over these last couple of laps, but he's very, very close to Cool Cat ahead now. And oh, a bit of lag once again. And looks like he's panicked there. And oh, he's lost his whole wing with DRS open there. And wow, that was just unfortunate, really. I think he sort of panicked because of the lag and tried to take a void in action, ended up getting a fishtail on the go. And yes, he just unfortunately lost his whole front wing there. And you just see the understeer. And here we go, here we're on board once again. DRS is wide open, panics there and just loses the rear. Fishtail was on over the track, straight to the barrier, whole wing gone. And he was a bit lucky actually there to not destroy his whole car, because that was some seriously high-speed stuff. Near enough 300 kilometers an hour, I'd have thought. So, and just look at that understeer. It's just, it's going to be the most painful lap. And it's, you know, not only that, when he comes round, he'll be onto his final lap of the race in the pit lane. So, but a little bit unlucky for Magnussen there, but it was car control at the end of the day. So he hasn't really got anyone else to blame, unfortunately, but himself. But I'm sure he'd be ruined that when he wouldn't have any championship points, which he was very, very nearly on for. On board with Wycombs now. And once again, look at those track limits. Beautiful stuff. So, yes. I tip my cap to you if I was wearing one Wycombs for those track limits.
Glad to hear it. And it looks like Wycombs is not done just yet. He's got one more lap to try and get by Nikki FD here. And he's gotten very, very close. He's going to try a diving move through the penultimate corner. He's got the inside line. He's going to have to go around the outside through the final corner. But it looks like Nikki has just kind of really dropped off. And, of course, with the DRS detection zone being quite a ways back, Wycombs also gets DRS down this straight. And then he's going to get DRS again heading down towards turn number three. Magnussen, no surprise, understeers his way right off the circuit. Just doing a bit of lawn mowing now for the Albert Park people. And we're on board with Double D now on the final lap of this race. He's got a 3.2 second behind DeMarco FD and a 4.9 second up ahead to Hamish. So actually Hamish extending that lead that he's got currently. I hate to say I told you so, but I really don't. I did say that Hamish was looking really good for the win earlier in the race. But again, you know, that was before I knew that Honey Badger needed to pit again. I really didn't know what the circumstance was with people's strategies and everything. But Hamish looked a lot better in the second half of this race. He really struggled in the opening, especially when he had that three-wide moment. And Double D now is actually the one that's struggling as Magnussen destroys his vehicle. He's struggling the most out of everyone. And now Marco FD running right behind his teammate as we're coming to the end of the race. And Double D locking up. Has he lost his front wing? I think he has. His teammate goes through. Can Klawicki claim the final podium position? They're going through the final corner. He moves to the left-hand side. Now he's going to lose part of his front wing. And he's going to finish in fourth position just outside of the podium after nearly grabbing it. That's got to be very frustrating for Klawicki. What can Wycombs do, though? He's up into sixth position. Can he grab fifth position after the final corner with the great exit? He takes fifth position. Driver of the day. Driver of the day goes to Wycombs. No doubt about it. Here's the replay of Magnussen to find out what happened with him, because we did see that he destroyed his vehicle. Something tells me that it happened at the pit entrance. And I'm getting that sinking feeling here as we're approaching the pit entrance now. He just understeers his way right into that LG thing and just takes off his wheel. And I'm sure that's going to be the end of what was a very frustrating race for him. And let's see what happened with Double D here. Did he get a puncture?
I was going to mention it, actually. You know, before all this happened, his front left did look very, very worn indeed. And I was just going to mention this race might not be over yet for Double D. And then, sure enough, that front left, you know, his wing is fine. His front left is just completely destroyed. It's just giving him no grip at all. And that actually ended up almost causing two positions. But Klawicki there, as we saw, just unfortunately a little bit overcompensated, giving him a little bit too much room almost, and just trying to avoid the contact there. And Klawicki could have very, very nearly ended up on the podium. And you know what? I think my driver today is going to go to Klawicki, actually, although he didn't quite take the position there. You know, he lost his front wing, or lost part of his front wing, for no fault of his own. And you know, great fight back. They could well have ended up on the podium if it wasn't for that slight mistake on that final corner there. So I'll give my driver today to Klawicki.
Yep. Great drive from both of those guys, Wycombs and Kulwitzki. But Kulwitzki does come out ahead in fourth position. So they actually switched positions. The Marussias started Wycombs fourth, Kulwitzki fifth, but they finished in the other order with Kulwitzki in fourth, Wycombs in fifth. But of course, Wycombs was down into 10th. And they both did a three-stop strategy, so that's interesting to see. They both did the three-stop. Hamish, though, in the end, takes the win by 8.8 seconds because of the issues that Double D had at the end of the final stint there. He was just running right off the circuit. So what was a five-second gap became a 10-second gap, and that's also what allowed Marco FD to scoot ahead of his teammate and take that second-place position, despite starting in sixth. So Double D down a position from his starting position. Marco FD up four positions from where he started. Honey Badger in the end finishing down in sixth position, also with a three-stop strategy, but going for the softs at the end. His teammate Fissler as well going for that and ended up finishing right behind him. That was something we mentioned in qualifying, that the two Red Bulls were just so far apart from each other. And in the end, they ended up finishing not that far apart from each other whatsoever. Titan of Racing with an interesting strategy, going double mediums at the start and then a couple of stints on the super soft tires at the end. And it actually worked out for him. He finished narrowly ahead of Velcrack 91 for a Mercedes, but of course, or unfortunately, just outside of the points paying positions. Postis in the end, both McLarens actually in the end finishing outside of the points, which is very unfortunate for both of those guys. I'm sure they're going to be pretty disappointed in that. Of course, the Drivers' Championship looks exactly the same way as the race. I'll take this opportunity to go over the bottom part of the top 10, which was Nicky FD in eighth position for Toro Rosso, Lucas Schumacher in ninth for Williams. So in the end, Lucas did end up scoring points because, as I mentioned, he was kind of bouncing around. Cool Cat grabbing the final position in the points, grabbing 1 point for Lotus. Ferrari, with their double podium, are going to be leading the championship, and there is confirmation of that. Ferrari with 33 points. Toro Rosso not far behind, though, just 4 points down on 29. Marussia with 22 after a fantastic drive from Kulwitzki and Wycombs, our drivers of the day.
Team
total
of the
coincidence.
Day.
Yeah, exactly. Team of the day, even though they only scored 22 points. Red Bull with 14 points, 8 points down off of Marussia. Then a big gap, 12 points down to Williams with just 2 points, and then Lotus with just a single solitary point. But Mercedes and McLaren Mercedes yet to score points so far this season, so I'm sure they'll be looking to improve their fortunes in Malaysia at the next round, as I mentioned, which is personally probably my favorite track in all of F1. I know it's weird. I know it's very
weird.
Yeah, especially for the purists. You know, most people don't like the Tilke tracks, but I quite like Malaysia. I really enjoy that circuit. I particularly like the penultimate corner, the decreasing radius penultimate corner. I really enjoy that. Lots of overtaking as well. Two DRS detection zones, not just two DRS activation zones like we had here in Australia, which is good. Promotes lots of overtaking into the tight turn one. So looking forward to that one.
Yeah, interesting. Just in stark contrast to what you're saying, that I hate that penultimate corner in Malaysia. So should be an interesting race next race with such differing opinions. But at this point, I'd just like to give a good shout out to Double D, who did all this editing here. Me and Justin are just the commentators. And Double D did all the donkey work. We did all the editing. So so yes, shout out to him. Well done, Double D.
Which is not easy, because obviously I know Miko, and he used to do the editing for this stuff, and it is very difficult work. So there it is. Next round is going to be from Malaysia, as is typical, except for in 2014. 15 turns, 28 laps, expecting probably two or three stops. It's going to be the medium and hard compound tires. So we hope to see you next time from Malaysia. Thank you for joining me, Alex.
Yeah. Thank you. That's been good. It's always good to commentate, Justin. So yes, thank you.
And I hope to see you next time. And I hope you guys will join us for the next race from Malaysia. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.